Alrighty guys, so welcome back to my channel today, and we are doing the build and buy review for the Sims 4 Vampire game pack. And I want to let you guys know that I did receive a review access code from the Sims team themselves. So yes, I am so super excited. So yeah, so we're gonna go in and review and experience everything with what it has to offer for the build and buy. And I'm just so excited because I cannot wait to start building in the Sims pack and for the Sims pack, because building is what I do and building is what I love, and I love designing everything. Bear killer? Shut the front door and toddlers can use ancient bassinet. Oh my gosh, things just got better. Oh my gosh. But anyway, so I want to go and show you guys all the new build and buy objects that we got today. So we're going to start from the bottom because, well, actually, let's start from the top where all the new stuff is at. No. We're going to start from the bottom. Because at the bottom, I want to show you guys. Okay, so we got one new human quote-unquote bed, but we did get like four new kind of beds here because we did get three new coffins today. So we got a regular bed that is actually called Ancient Resting Place. Who comes up with these names? Like, I want to know. Everyone who witnesses the original tree must now be surely dead, with silken soft sheets and that carefully repel unnecessary rays of comfort, even with the oldest skin. Like Vladimir, oh my gosh, he has a wrinkly old crackly little skin. The ancient resting place is where you can catch a few Z's and a few V's, as you so read. Who comes up with these descriptions? These are amazing, I love it. And then right here we have the aged wooden coffin, which is a classic and traditional wooden coffin. So we have that one, and then right here we have the Paul's bearer of bad news. The sober and sturdier coffin is cut from quality stone and features metalwork that is built from the withstand of elements guaranteed to last a lifetime. I love it. And the last one, at least, we have the all-exclusive luxury cruiser. Ooh, I love this one. Oh, so it has energy 10, stress relief 9, and then discomfort relief 9. Oh, nice to know. So I definitely do like this one because it reminds me of like more of my older type of more rich, dead, undead, or dead Sims. But it does come in a sort of colors. I love this one more because it's, who doesn't love white and gold? Because white and gold really screams royalty, luxury, amazingness. It just screams rich. I just love it. And then this one only comes like a more of a darker tone. I like the white, and then this one comes in more of a scary looking tombstone. I like the black and white one though. I do like that one. And then for the bed, again, sort of colors. Do they have a purple one? Purple. Nope, they don't have a purple. Oh, I wish they have a purple one. Oh, wait, that is. It was literally like right in front of my face. I'm blind. Clearly, I need eye surgery. So please, someone bite me in the eyes, please. Anywho, so yeah, assortment of colors. I do technically like how they have the original patterns, like a more standard patterns, and then they have like the more detailed pattern type of look to it. So that's something I do like. So two different varieties of the vampire bed. So if you want to have like either, you can choose between a coffin or a regular bed for your Sims vampires to sleep in, if they want to be semi quote unquote normal, or they want to be like you know what? I'm a vampire. I'd rather sleep in a coffin all my life. But yeah, so that is a thing there. And then for next off, we do have three new chairs, which I honestly love. We have the egg-shaped chair. No. The top part reminds me of an egg shape, so that's what I think it is. Then we have this small little dining chair, and then we have another dining chair as well. So again, it comes in an assortment of colors. I do like the red and white one. No, I do like the red and white. And also, if you guys can't tell, I'm in the world of Forgotten Hollow. Be the perfect world to review all this stuff right here. Forgotten Hollow. Loving it. Oh, it reminds me of Valentine's Day, but more with blood. Yay. I'm so chaotically crazy. But yeah, so again, assortment of colors. Again, it has the regular pattern, and then it has the more detailed patterns to everything of this chair. Again, with the regular chairs just have the regular pattern, and then this chair has the regular patterns as well. And again, if y'all always want to ever send me screenshots of your vampires in these chairs and be like a royalty family, send them on Twitter. I love you guys when you send me stuff on Twitter. It's literally like, it makes my day. I really do like it. But I always want more, like, I always want more furniture in The Sims, because every time we get a new pack, like, I want more, please. I always complain, like, I don't really complain, technically. I complain quietly that I always want more stuff in The Sims, because, like, I just want it all. Like, just give it to me all. I don't care. Give it to me. But, so we have this nice little lounge chair. I wish we were, like, able to have, like, a pillow onto the side of this corner of this chair, like, this lounge chair. Because, okay, if you don't, like, your Sims could pose on this chair. Like, you know those, like, vampire shows, like, or, like, regular TV shows, they have this, like, type of lounge chair, and your person just, like, kind of lays their elbow on this pillow, like, doing a pose or whatever. That is something really cool. That's something that I just love. Oh, love it. Loving it. Same colors as the other chairs, and, like, this one is, like, more of your outdoorsy type of chair, more of your old graveyard chair. So don't bother Mr. Jensen when he's mowing his old decrepit grass. Like, don't bother him, because he will come at you with his pitchfork and knife. No, pitchfork and garlic. Don't get on his bad side. Trust me, I've done it. It ain't pretty. It ain't pretty. But yeah, so again, we do have this more luxury type of style, vintage, glamour, goth looking type of chair. I honestly cannot wait to make my own vintage glamour, gothic glam type of a build, or builds technically, because I do have a lot of ideas for builds in my head right now. So honestly, I cannot wait for you guys to see them. But next off, we do have an island, which I do love, and then it looks like the one from the base game, but we also do have a counter right here. But it does have like a different type of style. It's more of a marble, but a little bit of shine to it. Nice. I like it. A little bit more of a shine to it. It has a little bit more of a design to the doors to it. And then we do have the cabinets. Yes, the cabinets right here that we do have right here. So that's something that I do like. Only three different colors. Yeah, three different colors. Okay, that's fine. Three different colors. And then we do have two new dining tables. So we have a long one for your more big, broad vampire party ball extravaganza, whatever you want to call it, table. And then we also do have your more dining table, so the elegant Victorian table, and then we have the formable table. So if you ever want to make your own Victorian type of styled house, this is the table that you should use, because it has the word elegant Victorian table. You should use it. So I definitely think that people will make their own Victorian homes in The Sims 4 now that this game pack has come out. But then we also have the gothic wall shelf. So this is a wall shelf. I do have move object sheet on, because I can't be bothered to put a wall on. But yeah, we actually have this one right here, a wall shelf to place like all your you know, just do it now. But yeah, we do have like a wall shelf that we can actually put like our own little trophies on here, or other stuff that we can actually use for our little Sims to have. And what I literally screamed my little head off. I was like, what is this? Custom Victorian rug end? What is this? I was like, wait, don't tell me we can make our own rug like as long as we want. Like, I was like, what the heck is this? I'm like, we can make longer rugs. Look how long this rug is. This rug is longer than long. I'm like, what? I was so happy that we were able, like, I feel so happy now, even though there are a little bit of tears in here I can see from this one. Like, even though it's end piece, I can see a little bit of tear, but I don't mind that. But it might be just the flooring of the ground, whatever. But that is something I really do like. I love, love, love how we can finally make our own type of styled rugs now. I wonder. I'm just guessing. I don't know if we can actually do this, but let me see. Yep, nope, I was wrong. I was like, I wonder if we can make like our own little like diagonal, like our own little square, what's it called? Rugs, but we can't, sadly, but that's okay with me. But I'm kind of glad we were able to make our own long, no matter how long the length, we can make an infinite rug room as long as we want. That's what I love. That's pretty cool. But next off, I want to go up to the top technically, because that's where I want to start at. But we do have a sink here. It's called Gothic Pedestal Sink. So it looks like it has like a not a chain. No, that's the toilet. Okay, so just have a nice little style to it, a regular faucet one. So ever vintage glamour stuff pack goes along with this pack right here. In my opinion, it kind of goes hand in hand because the pack itself screams vampire to me. And then also we have this new toilet that has like a little drain pulley thing, a string thing to flush the toilet. Oh, I cannot wait to see the animation for. I wonder. I feel like your Sims, like, they use the toilet, but they can like pull the string to flush the toilet. That will be so cool. Okay, the next off, we do have a new what's it called? Bathtub slash shower. So this curtain's actually see-through. Because vampires, they don't mind being exposed to the world. They don't mind that at all. But I really do like how the bathtub is very, very designed at the bottom. And I do love the see-through curtain as well. And then we do have a new bar that I did see in the trailer. I did like a little analyzation of a reaction of the trailer. So I was able to find a new bar that we were able to use. Again, these are all your elixirs and your blood and whatever you want to call it back in the back. And again, another assortment of colors to fit your Sims' needs. I feel like someone's going to make a Roman Gothic church for some reason. Like, in my mind, I feel like someone's going to make a Roman Gothic church. Just put that out there. Someone should do it. The Great Symphony or Hatsy, anyone, or Vixella, anyone. But yeah, so next off, we do the main one. We have a brand new skill called the Pipe Organ skill. So people thought that the pipe organ was only like for the piano skill, but this is actually your own separate skill that you can actually use. So we do have a new skill that we're able to use. So it's called the Pipe Organ skill here. So it's very, very huge, and it actually has a bunch of new songs that your regular Sims can use. Well, technically your regular Sims can use the vampire songs or the more. Let's just say, there's new songs in this game pack that are really, really cool. So, I really do like it. So, the pipe organ can pretty much play any song. I just love this pipe organ. It just screams vampire. It just screams gothic. Ugh! Give me the feels and the reels today. So, the next stuff I really am excited for, the most excited I am for, is the small wall, the medium wall, the small wall hole, medium hole. I'm like, well, hold up. We can scale these up. I like Sim Grew House. If you're watching this video, praise to the Lord Jesus. Thank you. I love this. I really, really do. I cannot wait to make my own living mansion that is so decrepit and ugly and old. I am literally living for these wall. I'm literally living for these wall holes. You have no idea. Multiple holes in the wall. Like, this makes so much more sense. Like, I really, really do love how everything is so detailed. The build and buy objects are by far the best things I've ever, like, seen so far. Like, I love the cracks in the wall. They have different cracks. And basically, these cracks are movable. You can, like, put them anywhere on the wall. Like, to make sure that your houses or buildings or whatever are your style to your needs. And I'm mind-blown. Like, I just cannot get a large tear. Small tear. Oh, shut the front. Oh my gosh. Sim Grew House. Sims team, you slay. You slay. Slay me. Okay. But then I see, do we actually have a small water strain? Oh, so it's like a little bit of a dirt path. A little bit of dirt on there I can see here. So I like the dirt patterns here. Another large crack. So, large web vertical crack. And we got, what else do we have here? We also do have the single large vertical crack here. And you have the small chipping. Oh, I love the chipping on the wall. It just makes my day. Well, I wonder if we can change the nighttime. Oh, I can't really see it. Oh, but yeah, so that's something that I really, 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 really do love a lot. How this game pack really just makes it the game so much more diverse. Oh, you can see the wall, a lot more detail to it. That's what I really do like. Oh, give me the feels. And then what I also do love is that we get our own set of spider webs that look like exactly, like, if you, like, look back, they look like exactly real spider webs. Like, not the one from the spooky stuff pack, I think. No, spooky game pack or whatever. It doesn't look cartoony. It looks actually real to me, and that's what I love. I cannot wait to use these in my own personal gameplay, my own personal houses I'm gonna be creating. I really do love the new cobweb styles, and again, you can add them to the bottom, the top, anywhere in your houses that you want to make your own style houses, your gothic houses. It just really, really makes your builds more personal, in my opinion. So that's something I really do love. Ugh. Give me all the feels today. That's my little vampire over there, if you guys cannot tell. Because again, vampires can die from the sun, and I needed my little sin not to die from burning. So yep, that's the thing. So let me go and show you guys the other one. So let me see. So again, another sequence large crack onto the wall. But we do get this like new little rug wall decor that does come in a certain... Oh, the King of Plum Bob. The King of Plum Bob. Yes. Oh, man. I'm obsessed. I am obsessed. Oh, yes. Oh, golden. Yes. Okay. But yeah, so again, that comes in a certain amount of different colors. But I think this one actually comes... It does. Oh yeah. So I saw in the trailer. That... there were different type of style of photo frames, like this style, but it had different pictures in it. I was like wondering, like, I don't know if that's like a different frame that we can actually choose from, but no, it actually comes with them. This one right here. So you can see like there's like a vampire here. I believe this is like Vladimir when he was young, and then like his wife sewing up her wedding dress or whatever, or like some roses. I don't know, but this is so, so cool. Like, I really like how we're able to have this photo frame. Like, it's like different ones right here. And again, different like positions too. So Vladimir's at the top and the wife is on the sides. Oh man, just loving it. I love it. And then we get this other one right here. It showcases like the other Sims as well, some like family members. Again, something I might end up doing on my own, like making my own little custom content photo frames of my Sims as vampires and put them into these photo frames as themselves, just to kind of diversify my gameplay needs. But yeah, so again, we do have some new photo frames like that are kind of close together, but not too close. Loving it. And then I was looking at this photo, like this fountain, and I thought that this was from the Romantic Garden stuff pack, but no, this is actually from the Vampire game pack. So that's something that I really do like. It's like you have the old ones, and then you have like the more dusty, old, and just again assortment of colors. Gargoyle, you slaying my life today, boy. Stop. Yes, I love it. Like again, a gargoyle one can't get any better than that. Again, assortment of colors that make builds a lot more unique and different. And again, I was always like wondering, like. Let me just show you guys this right here one real quick. So vampires can't see their own reflection. Nope. Okay, stop. Lady, stop. I want to show you reflection. Okay. Yep, look at that. Okay, here's my vampire. Look at that. No reflection. Isn't that even cool? That's so cool. I love it. I just love it. But yeah, so vampires don't have their own reflection, and that's something I really do like, in my personal opinion. Makes the gameplay more real. And I'm a vampire too, so I'm right here. You can't see me because I'm a vampire. Hello, I'm gonna suck your blood. But anyway, but yeah, so next off, we do have this big old Vladimir hanging up a picture that is something that is really, really big and something that is like huge than gigantic. And we also do have Vladimir's wife, I'm guessing. I'm gonna guess that. But in a big old photo frame that is very golden, which I honestly do love. And it looks like we have like an arranged marriage going on here. Scandalous secrets are going down in the Vampire Hall, Vampire Heights, Coffee YT. And then we do have a new curtain, which is so brand new. This review is going to be so long. I don't care. I just want to review everything to an full extent for you guys to see on my behalf of my personal view and what I think. But yeah, so we do get another new curtains. Slay my life. Oh my gosh. So we do get 3 new curtains today, and I honestly think that these are like the most iconically well-designed, well-structured curtains I've ever seen in my entire life, because again, these curtains have ties on it, and look at all these like the swaying of the curtains, the backside, everything looks so amazing. Is this new music? No, it's not. But no, we get 3 new podiums today, and then also we get a new gargoyle that we can actually place onto the podiums ourselves. Like, if you want to like have like a have your gargoyles protect your mansion or your family or whatever, you can set these podiums outside and put the gargoyles on top of them. That's something that I really did like. And in my review video, someone pointed out that this is a new new statue that we were able to get. It was actually the fairy. I thought that this was like part of the base game itself for some reason. I don't know why I thought that, but no, this is actually a new object that we were able to get. It is called the Kneeling Fairy Gargoyle, and then one is called the Wing Imp Gargoyle. Nice to know. Nice to know. And then the Grand Century Curtain, certain, okay. Widow's Peak Mirror, and then this one is like the Glided Bat Mirror. Count Vladimirus Strand the First, and then the Hanging Werewolf. Werewolves? What? Well, Hanging Werewolf Wall Jumper, the Stone Face Wall Fountain, and then the Ancient Family Portrait. Moonlit Rose in the Garden, and then the Stubberry Tapestry. Oh, okay, that's nice to know. Okay. And then this one right here, it reminds me of Aphrodite for some reason. I don't know why. But then it's like the Forgotten Woman statue. So the true history of this, history of this woman has been lost to the vagaries of time. Where did she come from? Is she smiling? Why does the cloth on her arm drape so low? So many questions. So, Krill Sims, if you want to do a sim facts video about the sim of the statue right here, let me know, because I will love to watch. But then we have this like new other statue right here that I honestly thought this was like a llama, goat, vampire, bat looking thing. What is it called actually? It is called the Wing Llama of Death. Well, now that I know, it is called the Wing Llama of Death. So it's a llama. Oh yeah, of course, because we wouldn't have other animals in here at all. So we would have a llama, which I honestly love. Llamas are flipping amazing. Who doesn't love them? But yeah, so this llama is very, very, very cool. And again, you can also have your other, like, different type of gargoyles. Like, you can either place gargoyles yourselves on podiums or... Oh, so it's like... So you have two different options. So you can either place gargoyles yourself on podiums or they come with the gargoyles on the podiums. That is pretty nice. I like that. And again, you can also place the statue onto a podium as well. Just so you can have this statue raised higher to the ground. And then with the toddler update that we got a couple weeks ago, we were able to get the Sims team added tombstones to the pack, to the update. And I was like, what you be doing, Sims team? Why you teasing us like that? Why you do that? But no, so we get four new tombstones right here. So we get the regular standing ones that are right here, and then we also get the tilted ones. So these are right here, which I honestly do like how, I really do like how they're very different technically, because I feel like that tombstones are either straight or they're slanted or they're knocked down. Either way, I like how they're both like different and they both have like the same type of style to them. So it makes it a lot more better. But then we also do have the Victorian floor rug, and this rug is giving me the feels. And again, who doesn't love objects? Who doesn't love the style of, like, giving me life? Oh my gosh, wait, whoa. What is this? Are these tears in the rug? Ooh, oh my gosh. I love these tears in the rug. It makes it look so old and ugly. I love it in a good way. But yeah, and then also we get a new fireplace. Oh my gosh, I'm seeing stuff. Giving me all these objects. I can't express how much I love it. But then we also got a new fireplace, which I honestly think that we were like needed for a new fireplace. The new fireplace we got was from vintage glamour stuff anyway. So, well, no, technically from, yeah, vintage glamour stuff. But for the holiday update, we got a new fireplace. So not that long ago, like last month. Okay, but anywho, but yeah, so that is something I really like. So we got a new fireplace. And then we also did get, let me just put this place out here so I can get clear of that. But we also got another Victorian, so I can see a lot of Victorian styled builds coming to the channel, along with some other channels as well on YouTube. So we got some Victorian styled objects, again, vintage Victorian, Victorian, Gothic, everything screams vampires to me, so that's something I really like. And then we also have like this one right here, and I don't know why, but the Sims team probably knows me so well, because I'm playing crazy, lush wall ivy. Oh my gosh, the feels, this ivy, oh, this ivy is giving me the feels. I feel so motivated right now to like just build right now. Like, I literally love, I love making old styled houses so much that I'm like, thank you for more ivy. Thank you for making my builds more plant crazy. So we have a super wall ivy as well. So if you ever want to make your own little wall, like tree, ivy wall on your side of the house, and you have your teenagers to sneak up to your other teenager's bedroom, by all means do that. I just love it. It's so cool. And then we also have like another more stout look, more oldie looking style. Oh my gosh, what is this? What is this? What is this? Oh, we have bristles. We have old looking bristles onto our. I love this. Bristles make my issels. Faux shizzles, my nistle. Okay, I need to stop. I'm not that cool. But still, I really love how like we have old style type of like, oh, it's so good. So good. And we also have like more details. Look, I like how they have small, medium, and large, and more extra ugly looking type of vines. I say ugly in a good way, so hopefully don't take the wrong way, but I generally think that these are ugly in a good way. So anywho, but I think that this one right here is my favorite because it's like a raven dead bird. So it's called Cuckoo. Oh, I almost said Cuckoo for Cocoa Pup. Cuckoo for Cocoa Pups. I almost said that. No, Cuckoo Kahoo Skull. The long extinct Cuckoo Kahoo not only resides to the class display cases of scientists and those people, wealthy individuals. Oh my gosh, modern iron radiator. Oh my, I've been waiting for the Sims to add radiators back to the Sims because I really do like radiators in general to make my builds, because I do, like, for a long while, I have always been wanting to make my own, like, old style houses, but I never really, like, had a radiator that fit that style for the inside of, like, for a living room, technically. But now that we have it in this game pack, good enough for me. And then for this one right here, oh, so it's just for environment. Okay, so I said in my review video, I was thinking that this book right here was technically for, like, I don't know, for spells to conquer up new ways to manipulate your Sims. Like, I know supernatural powers are for vampires, but I thought that this would, like, basically come be, like, a recipe book for your Sims, like, make recipes for their guests or something like that. I don't know. I thought that was, like, something that we can actually interact with, but nope, sadly we can't. It's just an environment thing. And then we have a large decorative urn. That's not large. This is large. This is a large decorative urn. That's what I call large, but nope. Someone should make, but yeah, so we have a new urn, which is very, very decorative, about I say. I really like how, like, some of the urns are very decorated, like, very decorative, but not decorative as this one, which I think that is something that we were well needed for. And then we do also have a new cabinet that we can actually not use, a neo classic floor cabinet. And for your vampires can actually have babies. So with that, you get a new bassinet here. So you get the new bassinet called the Ancient Bassinet. And even though when you have vampire toddlers and vampire children, your people can use this bear-cula thing right here to the full extent. So your toddlers can use this, your children can use this. So toddlers have a new skill called the communication skill, and then children can only have the social skill and the creativity skill for this certain object, which I think that is so cool. Like, look at his little wings and like his little bat tail. Oh, his little snout. giving me life. So we also have like some other colors as well, and then this one has only a few colors as well too. So that's something I do generally do like. So let's see, another colors here. And again, if you have the vintage glamour stuff pack and this game pack right here in the base game, I think that you would definitely, and you're a builder, you are gonna have like the best of fun with making very, very Victorian style houses with this pack. In both packs, like, that's my general opinion. I feel like if you have those two packs, you will have the best time ever. Well, technically just buy all of them, because it's like, why not? But yeah, so it's pretty much what we got here for that there. Some new lanterns, new candles. We can actually make stuff lit enough. So let's see. Yeah, some new lanterns here. And let's see here. Oh, chandeliers. Oh my gosh. Wait, new chandeliers. Oh my gosh, chandeliers. And some new candles in a, what's it called? Candles in a cage. Yeah, but again, we got that chandelier's all the way up. Oh my gosh. But yeah, we got a new chandelier here, so you got some candles on top of it, so if you ever want to use that, there it is. And then next off, we do have a nice little, such a tassel floor lamp. Years and years of design renovations went into this lamp. It ships in 192 pieces. Yeah, 29 pieces, and the instructions are in three different dead languages. The tassels need to be removed and cleaned once a day. Just enjoy how good it looks once it's set up. True that. True that. I respect that. True that. True that. Because it's looking a little bit dusty here. A little bit dusty. Yeah, you can see that. Oh my gosh. I don't know why. I literally love white and gold so much already. I literally love it. And then we also do have like another little chandelier. Oh, another little small little chandelier here too. A little bit more of a higher up chandelier too. And then we also do have a wall chandelier to put onto your walls. So that's something that we are able to get there. Oh my gosh, I just love all these objects. And then we also have an endless timepiece for, we have a new grandfather clock for your Sims to adventure into. Well, not really adventure into, just to kind of have. And then reclaim prime wood wardrobe. So we do get a new wardrobe for our Sims to technically use to undress, redress, recreate, plan, whatever they want to do. We have a new wardrobe here. And that's pretty much all the build, well, all the buy options we're able to get for the vampire game pack. So on to the buy, well, the build stuff right here. But I do want to show you all the new rooms that we're able to get here. So we do at least get 7 new pre-made rooms. So if you are not a builder or a decorator, you get 7 pre-made rooms already given to you once you get the game pack. So we do have the ancient laboratory, whatever it's called, words, yeah. So yeah, we do get that one right here. And honestly, I just honestly like how they're well designed and they're really, really cool. It's something that I really do like. Very like the, again, the see-through curtain, giving me life there. And then right here, we do have the Anthony's Chambers. So if you were to have like a vampire in the dark in the decrepit woods, you have this, and it does cost 7,000 odd simoleons here. I do like the more darker tone of this right here. It's something that I really do want to use in my own gameplay, technically, for my current house, because my current house is going to turn to vampires like real quick. And then we do have the antiquated bedchamber. That's a little bit more expensive because it does have more of a luxury type of style to it. Again, it does have more style to it than others. So that's something that I do technically do like, again, with the radiator. Again, it's just something I just love. And then right here, we do have the Ascendance of Darkness. Oh my gosh, what? It's like a little, like your little playroom. I'm gonna connect these rooms, actually. Oh, I love it. Oh, wait, is this a new floor? This must be a new flooring, actually. But yeah, so we got this other, like, organ room here. And then next off, we do have the Refined Den. Is it really refined? Is it really refined? Is it a really refined den? But either way, we do have a new refined den with the bar, and then we have the fireplace, and then again, because vampires don't watch TV because that's a lot of sunlight, they don't need that there. And then we have the Wall of Devouring, so this is where you pretty much go to have your little human Sims just go ahead and come here and suck their blood, whatever you want to call it. But yeah, it's like a little nice little quaint luxury dining room with a, well, words on luxury with the holes in the wall and your little webs and little the stuff on the wall. Yeah, not looking so hot there, but yeah, that's pretty much what you got here, there, and everywhere. And then you have your own little personal backyard that's kind of ground, so immortal resting grounds here. So yeah, so it's like your own little personal graveyard that your Sims, your vampires can go to, technically, to go ahead and sit here and reflect on life. And I honestly love these recolors of the vines, like the dead vines. Wow, just blow me away with more. Just give me more, please. Again, I just need more. So that is pretty much all the 7 rooms that we're able to get here. But let me go and show you guys the build stuff that we actually get. So again, if you guys don't know, I'm plant crazy. So we do get 7, actually, let me show you all of them. So we get 7 new plants here. So let me go and remove this real quick. So we do get creepy thorns right here again. And we also get some new dry rose bush. We get the painted fern, which I honestly think that with coming to building style, it will really help to make more builds more developed. And then we also have this dry pine. So if you want to like ever make your own cabin in the woods, or like like your own personal cabin in the woods, or your more dark and decrepit graveyard, or whatever you want to call it, you can basically use this pine and stuff like that. And we also have the staggly tree. And I love this like dead hawthorn tree. It's so huge. My Jesus Lord. I wish... Can we interact? Oh my gosh, wait. Hold the phone. I really want to see. Hold up. Can we... No, we cannot. Wait. Nope. Okay, we can. So I thought we were able to get a secret world with this, but we did not. I wonder if we can. Probably not. But anyway, back to this lovely area here. So let me go and show you guys the other stuff that we got here. I think that was pretty much it, though. No. There is a bare pine tree. So this is a very, very long pine tree that... That's a lot of stuff here. There's a lot of stuff to explain and explore. But either way, yeah. So for the wall structure, we only got one new wall structure here. So we got the gargoyle howl. So that will pretty much go onto your Sims walls right here. So it's a pretty much of a gargoyle's face that you can actually use to protect your own Sims houses, that I'm guessing. And then over here, we do have a new little on it Victorian wall line. Again, it does have a little bit more of a nice style to it. Nice to know. And then we do have new pillars. We got two new pillars. So we got the ornate Victorian column. Again, it looks like more of a base game one, but more developed and more structured. And then we do have the architectural spine. Oh my gosh, loving it. And then we also do have some new fences. We got four new fences. So we got the iron Victorian fence, which you can see pretty much right here. So again, certain of colors, it does match with the fence right here, which I honestly do love, not gonna lie. It just gives me life. So again, that is something I am looking forward to. Some more builds to come. We have the more neostatic slim fences. And then we have the concrete Victorian fences. And then last but not least, we have the iron railing. So four new different style of fences that you can use for your own personal garden. And then we have the long awaited gated luxury fence that you can use if you want to have like a gated community. Use this to your full extent. I just really love how everything's like really, really detailed and very like well styled. Like, I really do like how everything is really, really unique and different. And we have two new railings, might I say. So I'm gonna put some stairs like right here real quick, four quickies. And then let's see. So we have one new railing right here. And then we also have this other railing right here too. So they have two new railings that were able to fit here and there. So nice to know for sure. And then for the windows, we were able to get four new brand new windows for this new game pack. And again, I think that this is pretty, pretty cool because I like how everything's kind of, again, everything's different, which I really do love. So I like how this, it's like one big window, which is so, give me life. And then we also have this other one right here, more of a girl, if you want to live, what's it called? Ah, man, I almost saw the show and forgot, the name has escaped me. But yeah, so we get four new brand new windows, technically. But yeah, more, I would say this is like more your, if you are ever living in the city. Man, the words come, like, the word is escaping me. It's gonna come to me later, I don't care. But yeah, so we do get some new windows, of course, which I do love. You gotta have new stuff for this, like, stuff like that. Oh man, yeah. So we also get, I think we get two new doors with this new game pack. Let me just filter this up. Yep, two new doors. So we get more of a front door look window right here. And then we also get another grand scheme, loving that good old scheme window. Again, so many of colors. And yeah, I don't know why I'm saying this, like, yeah, and a certain of colors all the time, but that's how I generally do feel. I really do like how everything's really, really different. And again, you can never stop with the new wallpaper. Like, who doesn't love this? Like, who doesn't love all this wallpaper? Like, I love wallpaper. I just cannot get enough of this wallpaper. This wallpaper is like my life. Wait, is this like another? Oh, so we get like another siding. Like, get like more stone siding to this wall. Words. But then we get some new luxury type of dead flowers and roses and other stuff onto the wallpaper. And again, another sort of other wallpaper too. And then again, I feel like this would go more with the vintage glamour stuff. But again, I feel like vintage glamour stuff and this game pack right here really go hand in hand a lot. I really think that it really does. So that's something I really do like there. And again, different type of style of other wallpapers that you can technically use for your own builds. And this one right here is my personal auto favorite because it does really scream more luxury to me, because the way it's styled and like the walls and everything like that, it does really scream luxury. A lot of luxury to me, not gonna lie. So the next off, we did get brand new flooring. We got six new flooring. Again, words cannot express. I cannot say any words anymore. But let me go ahead and show you guys a proper way to show you guys showcase. So you got two new brand new carpets. Well, actually, no, four. Four new brand new carpets, I believe. But no, we got, oh good, just a lot of new flooring. Some new wood flooring, and then we also got some new tiles, some new carpets, and again, a lot of assortment of colors. I'm not sure if the carpet changes colors. Well, it does change colors, but I was wondering if it would change like different styles to it. But it doesn't. But yeah, nevertheless, I'm pretty happy with this game pack, and I'm pretty happy that EA was able to give me a copy of this. And if you guys want to purchase this yourself, go ahead and check the description below. I will link the Origin link to their website too, so you guys can able to purchase it yourselves. If you guys want to experience vampires, your own personal gameplay, by all means, do it. And last but not least, we got some new roof decor. So with the new roof decor, it's something that I was thinking that we were able to get anyway. So again, gargoyles, you gotta protect your house with the gargoyles. You gotta have it. It's a necessity to have in your own personal house and your house in general. So that's something I just love to the full extent. And we also have like a nice little window. So I feel like that I would make my own little Series and Unfortunate Events house. So I feel like if you don't know, Lemony Snicket, Series and Unfortunate Events, that house really, really screams Victorian to me, because I really think that I want to make my own little house from that series in The Sims 4. So I think that'd be really cool to do in the near future or sometime soon. But yeah, I think that's pretty much it. Yeah, I feel like that's pretty much it for all the build and buy objects. So, so I really hope you guys really much enjoyed this review. I know it's pretty long. I'm sorry, but I wanted to fully review this pack and all the objects set to a full extent to my liking and to my knowledge of what I think that I want to say, and I want to do better at reviews. So anywho, I hope you guys really much enjoyed this review as much as I did. If you want to check out my cats overview that I did like pretty much a couple minutes ago, probably, I'm not really sure, but yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed it, and yeah, just let me know what you guys think about this pack so far, and I will see you guys all in the very next video. Bye.